We don't need no mistletoe. We don't need no fireplace, but I'll keep you nice and warm. Are you down for some of these milk and cookies? Down for loving you, be my drummer boy, and I'm the only drum that you're gonna play.
Hey guys, it's Haleycreates, and today I'm doing 3 Christmas DIYs. So, some of these were already made because last year I went through like a whole phase of making like super cute crafts, so I thought I'd bring them back out this year and show you guys how to make them. I hope you like these DIYs, and if you do, click the link below and subscribe. I would love to be friends with you guys, and I hope you guys are having fun this Christmas, even though it's only November, obviously. I'm Christmas, and these are so cute. These are from Dollar Tree, by the way, in case you guys want them. So yeah, have a good Christmas.
This first DIY is a mason jar snow globe. I thought it was so cute. I tried it at Urban Outfitters because they were doing a little project in the store, and then all of a sudden it blew up on Pinterest and Instagram and all that, so I figured I would show you guys how to make it affordably and easy. What you will need is a mason jar, and you can find that at Vaughn's or Michael's, pretty much anywhere you go. And next you want to get some mini trees, you can also find that at Michael's. And next you're going to need hot glue. You of course don't have to have hot glue, but it does make it a lot more sturdy. Once you have your supplies, you're going to start by taking the jar lid that comes with the jar, and you are going to stack up some trees, whatever you want, because this is going to be the core of the project. You can always put like a little car in there and put some trees or whatever you want, and it'll all look really cute once you put in some fake snow. So choose your trees wisely. I chose this funky little twisted one. And next you're gonna hot glue those down, making sure that you be careful because it is very hot. And once you have those hot glued down, you can put in your fake snow and give it a little more pizzazz and kind of hide the little things inside. And you're pretty much done with that part, and you can just put on the lid and screw on the little cap, and it's all done. Next, to make the ribbon and bow that you're gonna tie around the jar, especially if it's a gift, you're going to wrap the red ribbon around the lid of the jar because it looks better when it's around the lid. And you're just going to see how long it is about, because you can always trim it. And then once you've got that length, you're going to cut it and make sure that you leave a little bit of excess because you're going to have to glue it. And then once you have that, fold your piece of ribbon in half so that it's kind of thinner and not as awkward. And then once you have that, put on some hot glue and make sure it's nice and even with no bubbles, and that'll give you a really clean look. To make the bow, you're going to take a small piece of ribbon, however long you want, however you want the bow to look, and you're going to tie it kind of in a, like, however it looks, I don't know how to explain it. And then once you have it like that, glue the seams so that it's all one little circle, and then start folding the ribbon in the center, kind of like a back and forth type of fold. And you can literally just pinch it and it already looks like a bow. So once you've done that, just basically put some glue or put another ribbon in the middle and you have a perfect little bow. I just realized that this bow that I made that was like a year ago looks way different than what I just showed you how to make. So you guys can ignore that. You can still make a bow the way I showed it. This was just from a long time ago, so yeah, sorry. Next up, this is a super easy room decor option, especially if you want something just to decorate your little jewelry box or something like that. I like to put these little boxes under my tree when I have my Christmas tree up, just to look a little bit decorative. So first you're gonna need a box of any size. It could just be like a card box or whatever, some scissors, and of course wrapping paper. So when you get the wrapping paper, you're basically just going to wrap the box like you would a present, and I'm not the best wrapper, so I would not, like, reference me, so good luck. One great hack for this actually is to ask your mom to wrap your presents, and wrap this box the way you want it because moms are usually amazing at wrapping, so there you go. This next DIY is a cute little snow globe type of ornament, and to make it you're gonna need a ornament thing from Michael's. I don't know what it's called, but just look for that. And you're gonna need some bulbs and some cute little decor that you can put inside of it, and some baby trees, or you can put a car or whatever you want because this is your project, so personalize it with stuff that makes you feel happy, or maybe if it's a present, put in something that somebody else likes. And to finish it off, you're gonna need some fake snow or glitter, whatever works for you and is less messy. When you're making it, it's best to put in the snow first and kind of file it in there or funnel it in there, because it's going to be a lot less messy and snow gets stuck to everything, so just an FYI. And then once you have that, sometimes I like to put a little bit of glue on the bottom of my trees, but of course you don't have to, they can just sit in there. And I put in my trees and everything underneath the snow so that the snow kind of goes above it. I don't know, just kind of play around with it and see what you really like. And if it's going to be a gift for somebody, I recommend gluing it down. And maybe not putting in the loose snow, maybe like the fur, because that's a lot less messy. Have your own fun with it and see what looks good. And yeah, put it up on your tree. If any of you guys tried this, I would love to see it because it inspires me to do even more DIYs. And it would make me so happy to know that you gifted somebody something that I put on my channel. So of course, contact me on my Instagram and stuff, and you'll see that in the outro.
Hey guys, I hope you liked the video. I had so much fun shooting this because it looks so cute in my room right now. And I love making DIY crafts. So if you see something you want to see me make, then tag me in it, show me it, I would love to make it. And I hope I can do some more Christmas videos for you guys this season. And we'll see you next time.